Hi everyone, it's TutorialsByN today, and today I'm here with this bracelet called the Triple Braid Bracelet. Now, I think this bracelet using this color pattern looks a little bit like checkers. Not that much, but it's basically like a fishtail with two different colors and a little bit of a frilly end, and I'll show you how it looks on the side. So you can also wear it this way, but you'll need to push in. So it sort of lays flat, but if you want to wear it this way, you have to push it that way. So it lays flat that way. Okay? So now, there is a bracelet called the Frilly Braid Bracelet, and it looks similar like this, but it's a little bigger, and it's made on the full loom, and it's made by TutorialsByN, and she has a very good channel. She has an excellent channel, so you should definitely go check it out. But without further ado, let's get started with making the bracelet. So to make the bracelet, you will need a hook, which I'll be using the Ramblin' Metal Tipped Hook. Rubber bands. Today I'll be using glow-in-the-dark white. Let me show you the package. Glow-in-the-dark white. And I'll also be using black. Okay? Black. And last but not least, you will need 1 C-clip. Oh wait, and you'll also need, most importantly, a loom. Now you can use a rainbow loom, any loom actually, because you only need 2 pegs. So yeah. So let's get started. You're going to need your loom, and you're going to find any 2 pegs on your rainbow loom. Any 2 pegs will do. You can use any pegs actually. So I'll be using the middle pegs, and as I'm saying this, I'm just making sure that if you're a right-handed, you want the arrows pointing to the right, but if you're a left-hander, you want your arrows pointing to the left, and you're gonna hook stuff with your left hand. And obviously if you're right-handed, you'll be using it this way, and I am a right-handed, so I'll be using it this way. Putting my loom this way. So I'll be using these 2 pegs here. Well, these 2 pegs, as you see here. So the first band you need to put on is the cat band, which is this band here, which I'm using black. Amazing, that's the same color. I'm actually making the exact same bracelet here. Okay, so you're gonna place it on the 2 pegs. Make an X or figure eight or whatever you call it. So you get something like this. Push it down. Then you add on. You want to grab 3 bands. Okay? Okay, you grab 3 bands and you just place it on. So you get something like that. And you want to make sure that they're all in order. So you want to go ahead and grab your hook and just use your hook to circle it around the bands a few times so it actually is in order, making sure, and then you want to push that down. Okay? Then what you want to do is you want to grab the cat band and you want to hook it over. Okay? Then you're going to add on another band of another color. I'll be using black because I'll be alternating between white and black. So then it's a black time. Place it on. You want to push that down so it makes it easier. Okay. Then what you want to do is, this is a little bit confusing, but as you keep doing it, you'll understand it a little bit better. So it gets confusing at first. So first you want to bring the bottom band here. You want to bring that over the top. But on this side, you want to do an inverted fishtail stitch. Okay, but how can you do an inverted fishtail stitch with 4 bands? Well, let me teach you that. You're gonna go in the first 2 bands. You're gonna go in the 2 bands. So you skip the top band, go in the 2 bands, and you wanna grab the bottom rubber band. Okay? And you wanna bring that over the top and release it. Okay? So you wanna even it out to get a better look. It's more nice, I guess. And then again, you push it down to make way for more rubber beans. And you want to make sure it's in order. Okay, now I'm going to grab my white. And then you want to add it on the two pegs again. Push it down. Now you grab the bottom band on here. So this time you're going to grab the bottom band over here. So grab the bottom band and hook it up and over. Then on this peg, you're going to do an inverted fishtail stitch. So you go in the middle two bands, grab the bottom band, and you hook it over and release. Again, even it out. And that's really it. You alternate between the normal up and over, and you alternate between the inverted fishtail stitch. You grab your black band, lay it on. Ooh, sorry. Push it down. Then again, now we pulled over the bottom band over here. So this time we're going to pull the bottom band up and over here on this peg. Pull up and over and release. Okay, and then you're going to go in and do an inverted fishtail. So you go in this two band, the middle two bands, grab the bottom band, and hook it over. Okay? Just like that, so you get something like this. Okay? Then again, you add on your next band, and add on your white band. Push it down. Sorry, my hook just went in here. Now we pulled the bottom band over on this time, on this peg, so now we're gonna do that to the other peg. So you grab the bottom band, hook it over and release. Then you do an inverted fishtail stitch here. Okay, so I'm going to show you one more time before I'm going to teach how to finish it. Okay, this is the last time I'm teaching you. You add on your white band, add it on, push it down. You're going to do an inverted fishtail here because you did an inverted fishtail here before. So now you're going to grab the bottom band, hook it up and over. And on this side, you're going to just do an inverted fishtail stitch. So you're going to go in the middle two, grab the bottom one, and hook it over. So you can see your pattern starting to grow, your fishtail pattern. Or your braid starting to start. So you continue your bracelet until you get your full length. And now I'm going to teach you how to end it. Okay, so to end it, you're going to grab one rubber band of any color. Now I'm going to be using white because I ended on a black. So I'm going to add white because it's a pattern. And what you want to do is you're going to do an inverted fishtail stitch on both of the pins now. So you go in the two, grab the bottom one, hook it over. Go in the two, grab the bottom one, hook it over. So you get something like this. And then, now you want to grab the bottom two, hook up and over. Bottom two, up and over. And now you want to sort of fidget with it so it goes into order. Okay, until it gets into order. But it's going to get a little messy up there. And then hook the other one on one of the sides. Grab your C-clip. Hook it in. Oops, sorry. Grab your C-clip. And hook it in. Ooh, okay. Okay. That's it. You've got your bracelet. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video.